What's up, YouTube? So, if you've seen Batman vs. Superman, or if you've seen Captain America vs. Iron Man, well, this comparison isn't nearly as epic as that. However, it is a popular one. A lot of you have requested me to do a direct comparison between the HP Pavilion X360 and Lenovo's IdeaPad Flex 5 2-in-1 laptop. Both of these are rocking the latest 11th generation Core i5 processor. They're both Tiger Lake chips essentially. And of course, by popular demand, here it is. Keep in mind, this is not a detailed review of either laptop. I've already done those. If you're interested, I will leave links in the video description below. Feel free to check those out. What this is, in fact, is a high level comparison of some of the best features of these laptops, some of their highlights, what they didn't get so well, and kind of put them, you know, apples to apple kind of comparison so you guys can sway in one direction of which one might be better for you. As always, if you enjoyed this comparison, hit that like button, consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, let's get started. First impressions count, and don't let anyone else tell you otherwise. With that being said, the HP Pavilion X360 definitely has respectable build quality, so it actually has a metallic finishing both on the top side and on the inner chassis where the keyboard and trackpad are. It's worth noting you do have a couple of plastic elements across the laptop, particularly on the bottom side. This laptop has an overall weight of approximately 3.5 pounds, making it the heavier of the two laptops here today. On the other side, you have the Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 5. This guy right here also uses a nice mix of premium and standard materials. So again, a metallic top finishing, a metallic chassis. However, the bottom and some other areas have TPU elements to them. It's also worth noting this laptop weighs approximately 3.3 pounds, making it slightly less in terms of weight compared to the X360, but you'd be hard pressed to tell the difference unless you use an actual scale. Also, it's worth noting both laptops have fantastic hinges that have metallic finishes, and this should be the case because these are 2-in-1 laptops. Let's briefly talk about the inner chassis design. So the trackpad and keyboard area, as you'll notice, have a reasonable amount of palm rest space across both keyboards, and they should, since these are 14-inch laptops, so they're not technically ultra compact by any means. Of course, with that being said, you'll notice the HP Pavilion X360 has a generous amount of trackpad surface space, which of course is great from a real estate perspective. Unfortunately, the actual quality of the trackpad is not nearly as good as it looks. What I mean by that is that you have a fair bit of imbalance when you click. Also, you'll notice that the clicks are not as tactile, rather they feel cheap and finicky often. In contrast to this, the Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 5 has a slightly better keyboard, so the clicks are a little bit more tactile, there's less imbalance when you press on any side of the actual trackpad itself, and overall, it is somewhat of a better experience. Things do get better for both laptops when you go to the keyboard. So the HP Pavilion X360 has what I consider to be a decent keyboard. What I mean is that you have a reasonable amount of key travel and you have a fair bit of tactile key press every time you press on any given keystroke. However, there is a little bit of wobble between each individual keycap, and this is noticeable particularly if you type on a lot of different type of keyboards like I do. With that being said, the Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 5 has an amazing keyboard. Lenovo's really nailed the art of making a high quality keyboard on laptops, and you definitely have a great amount of key travel. The tactile feeling is well balanced. It's not too aggressive, but it's not too subtle either. Also, there is practically no flex, no wobbling on any of the keycaps, and this is definitely the better of the two keyboards, particularly if you do a lot of typing. It's also worth noting that both these laptops do have 720p webcams. Neither of these are going to help you win any beauty contests. They don't do so well in low light settings, but they will suffice for your average Zoom call. Now, let's talk about the elephant in the room, display quality. So I'm gonna be very honest with you. When you look at these displays, you feel like you've gone back 50 years in time and lost all color. Okay, that's severely exaggerated, but just hear me out. So the HP Pavilion X360 starts off with a modest and respectable resolution of 1080p and 60Hz refresh rate. So far, so good. But here's where things go bad. You only have a sRGB rating of 51%. That should be illegal, seriously. Also, to make matters worse, you have a peak brightness of just 250 nits. So colors look washed out and bland. On top of that, if you're in an outdoor setting where the sun is shining against the screen or even indirectly, it's very hard to see anything on the screen itself. If you are a creative user who's heavily reliant on colors, you will definitely notice the lack of quality on the display. The average Joe might make it out alive without actually noticing too much color disorientation. The Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 5, and if you are an HP hater, you should really stop laughing, is not any better. So again, it has a respectable resolution of 1080p with a refresh rate of 60Hz, but it has a sRGB of 61%, which is ever so slightly better than the one on the HP Flex 360. But again, if you're a creative user, you won't really appreciate this any much more because that's still just too little in terms of the color department. In terms of brightness, it's even less at 240 nits at peak levels. Again, this is not suitable for outdoor use or really well-lit environments, and both these laptops have ultra-reflective screens, which means that you practically can use this as a mirror, and that doesn't help. In terms of performance, that's where things start getting different between these laptops. So believe it or not, both these machines have the exact same configurations for their base model. So they're both rocking Intel's latest 11th generation Core i5 processor, 8GB of DDR4 RAM, a 512GB solid-state drive on each one. Also, you have Intel's Iris Xe graphics, the latest Wi-Fi and Bluetooth standards on board. So when you're doing day-to-day tasks like web browsing or watching a video on the net or doing some good old word processing, both these laptops will breeze through it, easy peasy, no problem. Where you start noticing a visible difference is when you start pushing these laptops to their limits and start doing resource heavy activities. So let's say doing 4K video editing, you'll find that the HP Flex 360 has much less frame drops. It performs way more stable when doing activities like those. Let's say you're doing stuff like gaming. Again, the X360 actually has higher average frame rates. In contrast to this, the Lenovo IdeaPad Flex 5 actually gets considerably more frame drops, particularly when doing 4K video editing, and slightly lower average frame rates. The reason for this is actually one that often goes undernoticed, or correction, unnoticed entirely when consumers buy these laptops, and that's thermal management. The Pavilion X360 has an average surface temperature of 36 degrees Celsius at its peak load. In contrast to this again, the IdeaPad Flex 5 can hit up to 46 degrees Celsius under peak load. That's a 10 degree difference. That's massive for a laptop, which of course means that the Flex 5 has way more thermal throttling, which inevitably leads to lesser performance when you're doing resource intensive activities. If performance is a huge metric for you, if you are doing a lot of heavy activities, this is definitely something to take into consideration. One area where the Flex 5 has a visible advantage over the X360 is battery life. So the X360 with moderate usage at 50% brightness will give you approximately 7 hours of battery life. The Flex 5, on the other hand, will give you 8.5 hours in the exact same circumstances. And you definitely notice that hour and a half of extra battery life. So if you need all day battery, the Flex 5 is the better option in that regards. One area where these laptops are pretty much tied neck to neck has to be the stereo speaker setup on either laptop. So they're both top firing speakers. In HP's case, they did pair up with Bang & Olufsen, and I gotta be honest, the sound quality is fantastic as far as laptops go. It's clear, it's crisp, and volume levels are very much respectable. However, the Flex 5 is no slouch either. Again, top firing speakers and crisp and clear audio, volume levels are again very much respectable. The final area I wanna touch upon before I go into pricing and summary, of course, is a tablet mode. So both these are 2-in-1 laptops. So it's worth noting in the case of the X360 again, the actual stylus and the screen work fantastic together. There's little to no latency when you're doing any sort of task with the stylus, and it's a great experience in tablet mode. The Flex 5 similarly has a very nice experience. Again, very little to practically no latency when you're using the stylus. It is worth noting that depending on the region you're located in, the stylus may or may not come in the box for either of these laptops. Finally, let's talk about pricing. So depending on, again, the region you're in or the country you're in, the pricing will vary. At the time of this video, both these laptops are retailing for approximately $799 USD. Again, these prices may vary at the time you go to purchase these laptops. Keep in mind, given the fact that these are technically entry-level 2-in-1 laptops, I definitely think they both bring a fair amount of value. In the case of the Flex 5, its biggest strength has to be its high quality trackpad and keyboard. It really does provide a fantastic typing experience that you don't find on a whole lot of laptops. But when you look at the other side of the coin, the HP Pavilion X360 just hands down wins in the performance department. It is a more well-built computer from a thermal perspective, and you can definitely do more resource intensive activities for longer times with the Pavilion. But again, coming back to the Flex, if battery life is important to you, you may lean that way. So keep these considerations in your factors when you're buying either of these laptops. Neither of these laptops are particularly bad. I definitely think they're great value. Their 2-in-1 functionality definitely makes them a very lucrative deal. Also, if you can find the 16GB or 32GB RAM configurations, definitely consider getting those, as it'll help you future-proof your purchase. All in all, guys, keep in mind this was not a review of either laptop. I've already done that again. Links are going to be in the video description. This was a high-level comparison to help you decide what factors may be more important to you. If you guys enjoyed this video, if you find it to be insightful, hit that like button. Consider subscribing to my channel. It truly does help me grow. Thank you so much for watching. Take care.